No reprieve for motorists as pump prices are heading higher for a fourth straight week. Estimates show gasoline may increase by nearly 2 pesos per liter, while diesel and kerosene may see a 50 to 80 centavo hike. The Energy Department has been attributing the price hikes to the geopolitical tensions in the Middle East. The tires of a Philippine Airlines plane blew out as it prepares for takeoff Friday night. All 361 passengers and crew on board the Manila to Los Angeles flight are safe. The flag carrier apologized to passengers and swiftly arranged a replacement flight, which is scheduled to leave this afternoon. Manila's International Airport set to implement higher terminal fees by next year. Transport Chief Jaime Bautista says the fees at the NAIA may rise to 950 pesos from the current 550. This comes as the consortium led by San Miguel Corporation undertakes a 170 billion peso rehabilitation of the gateway. Bautista explains they need to compensate the concessionaire's investments, but he assures the public it will result in increased efficiency for the airport and a more comfortable experience for passengers. The Philippine Transportation Department eyes filing an arbitration case against Chinese railway manufacturer CRRC Dalian over the trains it supplied for the Philippines. Some of the so-called Dalian trains, which were delivered in 2017, were never fully deployed due to its incompatibility with the country's Metro Rail Transport 3 system. Transport Chief Jaime Bautista says the arbitration case may be filed before a Singapore court ahead of the MRT3's planned privatization next year.
Meron tayong konting issue dyan, no? Kasi yung na-deliver sa atin ay parang hindi natin in conformity with the agreed terms, no? mas mabigat siya. And the reason why we don't like to operate those trains at this time, no? Kasi posibleng maging mas mataas yung maintenance cost, no? Yung maintaining also the rail line, no? Might be affected also, no? It can result to higher operating costs also.
The Philippine Finance Secretary is optimistic inflation will fall within target this year due to government interventions. Secretary Ralph Recto says food inflation is expected to further slow once the tariff on imported rice is reduced from 35 to 15%. He says this is expected to pull down rice prices by 10%. He also touted the possible effects of the large-scale trial of the Bigas 29 program, which offers rice for 29 pesos per kilo to poor households. Inflation in June dropped to 3.7%, snapping a four-month acceleration streak. Year-to-date, it remains at 3.5%, well within the government's target. The Philippine Health Department eyes the distribution of unpaid health emergency allowances to COVID-19 healthcare workers soon. According to Health Secretary Ted Herbosa, healthcare workers will be able to receive their health emergency allowance within a month or so. This comes after the Philippine Budget and Management Department released 27 billion pesos worth of allowances on Friday. The funds will then be downloaded to the DOH, then to its regional offices. Local government units and private hospitals will then distribute the financial aid to claimants. Under the Republic Act 11712, healthcare workers are entitled to receive aid for every month of service during public health emergencies like the COVID pandemic. A new geothermal plant by the Lopez family's Energy Development Corporation rises in Albay Province in Bicol Region. EDC inaugurated the nearly 29-megawatt Palayan binary power plant on Friday, seen to boost the country's still fragile power supply, especially in Luzon. The 7 billion peso project harnesses thermal energy from brine, a byproduct of the company's 120 megawatts flash geothermal power plant, to generate electricity without the need for additional steam. EDC says the binary plant is expected to reduce the country's carbon emissions by an estimated 72,200 tons each year. The company adds it will build more geothermal power plants, saying it is one of the most reliable sources of clean energy.
During the time na nagkaroon ng Ukraine crisis, no, nag-umpisa yan, nag-triple, nag-times 4 yung pressure ng ibang technology, pero yung geothermal constant lang.
Ngayon nagkakaroon ng magandang opportunities para magamit siya. One is yung Japanese funding related to the equipment that we're using for these projects. At the same time, timing is right kasi kailangan talaga natin yung kuryente ngayon.
The Philippine government targets to increase the country's renewable energy mix from the current 22% to 35% by 2030 and about 50% by 2040. A significant breakthrough in the missing persons case of a beauty queen and her Israeli boyfriend. Authorities found a suspected burial site of the missing couple. Our correspondent Gracie Rutau joins us on the line with that exclusive story. Gracie, good afternoon.
Rica, on 7 a.m. this Saturday, July 6, 2024, authorities made a significant breakthrough when they discovered what is believed to be the burial site of Geneva Lopez, a Kapampangan beauty queen, and her Israeli fiancé, who had been missing for 2 weeks. The site was located in a remote quarry site in Barangay Santa Lucia, Capas, Tarlac. A key witness came forward with crucial information leading to the discovery of the body. The scene of the crime operatives unearthed the decomposed bodies of a man and a woman buried at a depth of over 2 feet. Authorities are leaning towards the belief that these bodies may belong to the missing individuals based on their physical features and clothing. The relatives of the victims are eagerly awaiting to possibly identify the bodies. Subsequent investigations, including autopsy examinations, will be carried out to determine the exact cause of their deaths and DNA testing and analysis to confirm their identity. And that's the latest here in Tarlac. Back to you, Rica.
Hi, Gracie. Just one question, please. This witness who gave the information, are the police holding him or her as a person of interest now?
According to authorities, they are considering this person as a key witness to solve this investigation, this case with a missing couple.
All right. Thank you so much, Gracie Rutau, reporting live. The Philippine Agriculture Department launches the large-scale trial of the government's Bigas 29 program. For more details, we have Jervis Manahan.
Thousands of people flocked to 10 Kadiwa stores as the government launched the large-scale trial of the Bigas 29 program on Friday. The project offers affordable rice to vulnerable sectors at 29 pesos per kilo. Agriculture officials say they are looking at further expanding the program as they visited the Kadiwa sites.
So far, maraming nagpunta, pero still we need to do the information dissemination na meron tayong ganitong programa, yung P29 program ng ating Pangulo para maka-avail yung mga nasa vulnerable sector. Dapat available at accessible yung pagkukunan.
By August, the number of Kadiwa stores taking part in the program is expected to double, including new sites in Visayas and Mindanao. Consumers laud the project, saying it gives vulnerable sectors access to affordable and quality rice.
Baka laking tulong po yung para sa tulad po naming mahirap na makabili po ng murang bigas dito.
Bibili ka ng bigas dun, 60 to 58 ang kilo, dito 29 lang, halos kalahati. Tingnan ko rin kung talagang patok sa magandang kainin.
The DA says they haven't seen any problem so far. But officials are appealing to beneficiaries not to abuse the program so more people can benefit from cheaper rice.
So far naman ay naging maayos at maganda yung mga koordinasyon ng iba't ibang mga kasamahan namin dito sa programa. Merong mga nagkaroon lang ng delay sa pagdating doon sa mga sites ng mga isda. Halimbawa, nagkaroon ng delays doon sa ibang produkto. Pero sa bigas, maayos naman. Yung ganitong programa ay magiging tuloy-tuloy dahil nakita natin ngayon palang first day, napakaganda ng response ng ating mga kababayan.
The Kadiwa sites will be open even during the weekend to accommodate more people. Jervis Manahan, ABS-CBN News.
A maritime expert says the Philippines can file another case against China if it remains firm in refusing to pay for the damages it caused during last month's tense encounter in a Union shoal. The Philippine Armed Forces is seeking 60 million pesos from China for damaging its military equipment and injuring in Navy personnel. But Beijing is not bowing down to the demand as it accuses the Philippines of staging the provocation. Jay Batombakal says this proves Beijing's supposed commitment to ease tensions with Manila is an empty promise.
yan po ay dapat ay isang item kung sakali na isasama siya sa ibang kaso laban sa China, no? Dahil nga ito ay isang ebidensya lang na patuloy na nilalabag ng China ang South China Sea Arbitration Award at ang international law. Kasi po kahit naman po sabihin natin, no, even for the sake of argument na mayroon silang claim doon, eh wala po sila talaga silang karapatan na sirain ang ating barko ng Republika ng Pilipinas. Yan po ay isang violation ng tinatawag na sovereign immunity. Huwag tayong mabahala na hindi sumasagot agad, no, ang China. Eh, habang tumatagal naman, eh, nakikita ng mundo na talagang hindi sila mapagkatiwalaan.
Meanwhile, China's biggest Coast Guard ship, dubbed the Monster, has been loitering Philippine waters for days now. The Philippine Coast Guard says it was last spotted in Escoda Shoal near Palawan. Majority of Filipinos want the Philippines to settle its maritime row with China peacefully. A recent survey by Pulse Asia shows more than 60% of respondents want a code of conduct to govern actions of the countries claiming the South China Sea. Nearly half also believe the Philippines should continue its diplomatic talks with Beijing, while others want China to pay for damaging the country's coral reefs. Only 8% said the Philippines should request U.S. military support against China's aggressive actions. At least 1,200 Filipinos participated in the survey, conducted from May 5 to May 9, before the June 17 Ayungin encounter. The release of the survey results also came days before the 8th anniversary of the historic arbitral ruling that invalidated Beijing's sweeping claims in the West Philippine Sea. The Philippine Coast Guard continues to track the movement of China's monster ship in Philippine waters. The vessel's presence comes in the wake of a bilateral meeting between Manila and Beijing. Let's get more details from our correspondent Michael Delizo. Michael.
Hi, Rica. Good afternoon. China Coast Guard's massive ship, dubbed the Monster, has been staying just less than 800 yards or some 700 meters from the Philippine Coast Guard's BRP Teresa Magbanua at Escoda Shoal. Based on PCG's tracking using Canada's dark vessel detection technology, PCG's 165-meter ship, CCG-5901, arrived at Escoda on July 3rd after loitering for 2 days near Ayungin Shoal, where the Philippines grounded its warship BRP Sierra Madre that serves as a naval outpost. It also deployed rigid hull inflatable boat or ribbed around Escoda. PCG spokesperson for the West Philippine Sea, Commodore Jay Targuela, said Magbanua has been issuing radio challenges to the monster ship in an hourly basis. The monster ship, however, has not responded on its intention but insisted on its sovereignty over the water and it is conducting maritime law enforcement operation. Among PCG's largest ships, the 97-meter multi-role response vessel, or the Teresa Magbanua, was deployed to Escoda in April to monitor Chinese activities over suspected reclamation works in the area. Escoda is a tiny shoal near China's military base at Panganiban Reef or Mischief Reef and a Ayungin Shoal as well as Palawan Island. China deployed its giant ship on July 1st despite the contact of the 9th meeting of bilateral consultation mechanism on the South China Sea on July 2nd. Well, former U.S. Air Force officer Ray Powell, he's the director of Maritime Transparency Initiative, Sea Light. He said that China deployed its giant ship. It is meant to project its force as it seeks to maximize its leverage in the consultations. Powell added that with China's projection of dominance, it will then insist on concessions in return for stability, noting that Beijing always estimates the escalation as the responsibility of the other party. Tariela also believes CCG's deployment of monster ship was meant to intimidate the country. Back to you, Rica.
Hi, Michael. Just some clarification. Mm-hmm. The monster on their tracking, has it been seen that the monster has been here for days inside Philippine waters?
Yeah. China deployed the monster ship on July 1st. It was deployed from Hainan, China, and then it went near Ayungin Shoal, and then on July 2nd, it returned. It went to Mischief Reef, that's the military outpost of China, and then it proceeded on July 3rd to Escoda Shoal. So it's been at Escoda Shoal for 3 days now, Rica.
Mm-hmm. All right. So we're also has it also been seen on waters in exclusive economic zones of different neighboring countries in the past few days?
Since it deployment on July 1st, mm-hmm. it only conducted its patrol in mm-hmm. the Philippine waters, Rica. Mm-hmm.
All right. Thank you so much, Michael Deliza, reporting live. Philippine Justice Department believes Guo needs to prove her credibility before becoming a state witness. The Presidential Anti-Organized Crime Commission earlier said Guo could become a state witness if she discloses vital information, especially on illegal POGO operations in the country. But the DOJ says divulging what she knows is not enough to be a state witness.
Wala pa naman ako nabibinig, no, na ganong intention na maging state witness. So sa ngayon, hindi po, wala pa sa lamesa yan. Madami mga requirements upang maging state witness. Isa na doon kayo yung disguilty at kasama na din doon na credible kang witness. So bago maging state witness si Mayor Guo o kahit sino respondent, kailangan maipotanayan niya itong mga requirements na to.
Guo has been facing mounting legal woes over her real identity, as well as her connection to illegal POGOs in the country. Her camp can file for a counter affidavit on her human trafficking charges during the DOJ's next hearing set on July 22nd.